Simone here with Women-Centric Media, and we are thrilled to be at the 10th annual Work Life Matters magazine gala, which is celebrating the companies that are well known for LGBT equality. You're going to be the keynote speaker. I just was wondering about your involvement, how you found out about it, and just your thoughts about how important this issue is.
Well, it's such a thrill to be the keynote speaker tonight. I was so honored when Dr. Sokol asked me, because I follow her work as an educator and reinforcer the importance of balance and respect for all people in the workplace and in the community, and the importance of getting businesses to recognize that diversity extends far beyond just the office walls, and the impact that these companies make when they make a stand to include people of all races, all genders, all minorities. It's just so exciting. And then to be standing there sharing the podium with Lauren Arbus, who, you know, I've said this is a woman who doesn't need to break any more glass ceilings. When they see her coming, they just shatter on her own. So this is just an incredible honor for me as someone who started off as an openly gay actor and then transitioned into public policy and advocacy for the gay community, and now also women's causes and education. It's just such a thrill to be able to spread my messages to this incredible dinner full of major business leaders who I hope take some of what we talk about back to their offices and try to expand on their already incredible work toward diversity.
Yeah, because, you know, it's one thing to have it in a mission statement, and it's another thing to actually enact it in everyday life and to deal with, you know, some people's sensitivity and a lot of people's ignorance, because maybe sometimes they don't even know what it is that they're doing wrong, and so they need to be educated. So hopefully it's all about companies stepping up and providing the right programming and education for their employees, right?
Absolutely. And what I'm here to attest is how incredibly pervasive that message is outside the corporate world. You know, when corporations like, say, Target, like IBM, like NBC Universal, who's here tonight, when they really put themselves out there to make sure that everyone knows how inclusive an organization they are, that trickles down. I speak to particularly high school and college students a lot. And recently at a shelter for gay children who've been kicked out of their home when they've come out, they've told me stories about how they know what companies look out for their interests, and they'll only shop there, they'll only let their friends shop there, and then they become consumers in just a few years. They remember the companies who look out for them, and they want to go work for them and support their efforts too.
Oh, I know that.
Right, so it, like you said, it's not just in the work environment, but it's everywhere, and the more that we're aware of what's going on, the more that we can, you know, make a difference.
Absolutely, absolutely. And you know what, it's all, as someone who's fortunate enough to work in the media, and like you are, the messages that you spread travel so quickly. There's a reason it's called going viral, because these messages spread so fast, and they make such a difference in a way that messages never used to be able to. So thank you for what you're doing, and I hope to extend what the mission that we are accomplishing here tonight with everybody else around the world.
Thanks so much. It was really nice meeting you.
See you soon.
Okay, bye-bye.